Today we will discuss about Mirage. Mirage is one of the application of total internal reflection. So this is one of the phenomenon of optical illusion, that when we have an object, say something like this, an object like a tree, now when during summer, only this phenomenon is observed, that when light from the top of this object moves towards the ground, during that the layers of air, the air which is here, they have variable temperatures. So the density of air is not same. Near the ground, the temperature is very high because it is a hot ground. So air molecules near the surface, the molecules of air which is near to the surface, they are very hot. So you say that the air is hot, very hot near the surface. As we move from the surface up towards the sky, then the temperature of the layers of air will decrease. That means if we can imagine the invisible air in front of you, if you can visualize that these layers of air are having not same density, they are having different densities. The densities of the layers of air which is near to this ground, as you move up, as we move up, we imagine that it is a made up of different layers of air. So just to understand the concept, we say that this medium is divided into so many layers, and the layer which is very near or close to the surface or ground is very hot, so temperature is very high here. Then here the temperature will be, the temperature of this layer will be lesser than the temperature of this layer but higher than this layer. So as we move off, the temperature will go on decreasing, so the density will also go on increasing, because high temperature means low density, the refractive index is also low for high temperature. So first thing is, if temperature is high, the refractive index will drop, so the layer will become redder. So when a ray of light moves from high above the top of the object towards the surface, towards the ground, that means when it moves towards the ground, so it has to encounter multiple layers of layers of variable densities. Rather, it is moving from higher density towards the lower density. Each time it crosses one layer and it moves on to another layer, it has to always find a error medium ahead of it. So that means when it that means the temperature here is high. If I think that its refractive index is mu1, its refractive index is mu2, mu3, and so on. And suppose this is mu n, these are the refractive indices. And obviously, what I'm writing here is that the mu n is greater than, and so on, layers greater than mu3, greater than new 2 better than new 1. So as we move from higher to lower, up above the ground toward the ground, the refractive indexes will gradually decrease. That means the ray has to travel denser medium to rarer medium. So as we know that when ray travels from a denser medium towards a rarer medium, this ray will bend away from the normal. It will bend away from the normal. So when the ray enters like that, this is denser and this is rarer. So instead of going like that, it will bend away. It will bend away from the normal. Again, it finds another medium. This medium is rarer compared to this medium. So instead of going like this, it will bend away, further away. So it will continue to move like that. Now this is a normal. It should have gone like that, but it will bend further away. So this way, it will move like that. So gradually, the ray will boom, bend like this, and a stage will come for TIR will happen when the angle of incidence for a particular interface will be greater than the critical angle, because the layer of air lying below is a rarer medium and the ray is coming from denser medium. So this condition is met, that angle of incidence is greater than critical angle and the ray is traveling from denser medium to rarer medium. So in such case, the total internal reflection, this will occur. So it will be reflected back, and as the reverse process happens, that means when it moves from rarer to denser, it bends towards the normal. So the reverse process will happen, it will bend like that. So basically the ray will move like this, like this. So it bends like that and moves like this. So the image of this object will be, the ray will bend like that and like this it will go. So ray coming from this top of the tree will bend and move away like that. So if an observer is standing here, if an observer is standing here on the ground, so what he observes is that to his eyes, the ray is coming like this. So the image will be formed when this ray is extended in the backward direction, and therefore here we'll see the image of this object. So you'll see the image of this object. This gives you the illusion that there is a water body here, or pool of water here, or a lake is there. So some kind of that illusion is established. So the observer thinks that there is water over here, and he rushes to the point only to find that there is nothing like that. So this is this type of illusion which gives you the feeling of the presence of water at a distant place during summer is this is known as mirage. And this happens in a very hot surface, whether it is summer season or whatever, but whenever the surface is very hot, and comparatively the air as you move from the ground towards off, the temperature will decrease and the density will also increase. So in that case this will happen, and this is known as mirage. Okay, this is known as, basically this is the concept of mirage. So here the total internal reflection will occur. So here it will bend towards the observer. Okay, thank you.